Good morning students, I am Pavan, your science master. This video is for 7th standard students. Students, can you recollect the points that what we have talked in the previous class? Yeah, symbols of electrical components and the sequence or order of arrangement of these electrical components in a circuit. Yes? Yes. And here, I am going to teach you about in a circuit, you take a bulb or you take a battery cell. In a circuit, in simple electric circuit, you can see only one bulb and only one battery cell, right? But if you want to use more battery cells or more bulbs, how do you connect them? What do we call the connections if you connect more bulbs or more battery cells? Let us take an example and arrange these electrical components. Okay, let's take let's take more battery cells or more bulbs. What shall we take? More battery cells. Okay, in a simple electric circuit, let us take more battery cells and arrange all the electrical components in a simple electric circuit form. But there is only one change, that battery cells are increased. The number of battery cells are increased here. Okay, let me show you that and explain. Yeah. Positive, long, tall standing line, short standing line. Sorry. Negative, copper wire. Okay. Yeah. Can you say the names of these electrical components? This is cell, this is bulb, this is switch. The switch is in off position. Okay, I wanted to put it in on position. Now it is in on position so that the bulb is glowing. Okay, now the arrangement of these electrical components are like this in a simple electric circuit, but I wanted to increase the number of cells here. I wanted to increase as many as you can arrange the number of battery cells like this. Positive, negative, positive, negative, positive and negative. See, the arrangement of these battery cells are in series. Okay, one after another. See, the negative terminal of first battery cell is connected to positive terminal of second battery cell, and negative terminal of second battery cell is connected to positive terminal of what? Third battery cell. And again, this negative terminal of third battery cell is connected to positive terminal of fourth battery cell. See, the order of arrangement is like this: plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. You can see here. Okay, right? Plus, minus, first battery cell, second battery cell, third battery cell, fourth battery cell. See, if the amount of current produced by this first battery cell is 1 volt. And how many battery cells are here? 1 into 4 battery cells are here. So total amount of current produced in this series connection is 4 volts. Okay students, 1 into 4 is equal to 4. Okay, 4 volts. So 1 is what? The amount of charge produced by one battery cell. And how many battery cells are here? 4 battery cells. But here the charge is added. Charge is what? Added. The charge is multiplied. Added means the amount of charge is increased. Okay. Amount of charge is increased in circuit. So here this connection is called series connection. Got it, student? This type of connection is called series connection. Okay, the battery cells are arranged in series connection and the amount of current is multiplied. The more cells you add, the more current is added, or the more amount of charge is added in the circuit. Got it? And then how the intensity of bulb will be? Okay, the intensity of the bulb will also increase. Got it? Intensity of bulb also increase. If you remove 2 battery cells from here, the intensity of the bulb decreases. How much it decreases? If each battery cell produces 1 volt of charge, then if you remove the 2 battery cells, 2 volts of charge is reduced. Okay? Yeah. Such an understanding is called, you know, series connection. This connection of battery cells is called series connection. Okay. Let me teach you another type of connection. In the same diagram, I will explain you in the same diagram, drawing like this. Students, I will take a rectangular box like this. Here one battery cell, positive and negative. Here what? Switch is on. And here what? Bulb is glowing. Yes? Now, we are taking what? We are connecting many battery cells. We are connecting what? Many battery cells here. Okay, you can increase as many as you can here, not only 4 here. Just for example, I took 4 battery cells here, but you can take as many as you can, as many number of battery cells you can add here. Okay, next, another type of arrangement is called, the name I will reveal later, but I will show the connection, how the connection will be. Here, how many battery cells here? First battery cell is this. Next, I wanted to take another battery cell, positive and negative. And also I want to take another battery cell, positive and negative. Okay? See, students, here the arrangement of battery cell. How many battery cells are connected here? First, one battery cell is connected. Then these battery cells are connected to this copper wire like this. Okay. One, two, and three battery cells are connected. And if you want to take one more, positive. Negative. Okay. If you want to connect the battery cells like this, you can. You can connect as many battery cells as you can. Okay. This type of arrangement will not change any brightness of the bulb here. No brightness is changed here. No brightness is changed. The brightness of the bulb is only due to only one battery cell. Only one battery cell. So if the battery cell is producing 1 volt of current, but the bulb, the intensity of the bulb is only because of 1 volt of current. Okay. If you increase the number of battery cells like this, there will be no change in the brightness at all. Got it? You can increase the number of battery cells as many as you can, then there you will not see any change in the brightness of this bulb. Okay, got it? This type of connection is called parallel connection. Parallel connection. Students, battery cells are arranged parallel. Okay, the position of the battery cells, you can see they are parallel. Got it? So this type of connection is called parallel connection. What is that? Series connection. Here we took many battery cells, but we can also take many bulbs as well. You have to take only one battery cell in the next type of the arrangement, in the next type of connections. You know, in the next type of connections, you take one battery cell and you take many bulbs. Here in this, you took one bulb and many battery cells. But in the next type, let us see that. Let us take only one battery cell and many bulbs. Okay. Yeah, how many bulbs are there? Only one bulb is there. You take another bulb. Here also one more bulb with only one cell. What will happen there? If the battery cell is producing only 1 volt of current, only 1 volt of current is shared with these three bulbs. Okay. And you can take one more bulb here. Yeah, 1 volt of current is shared with this four. You know, 0.25 of volt is shared with this one bulb, first bulb, second bulb, third bulb, and fourth bulb. And each bulb is glowing with 0.25 volts of current, because 1 volt of the battery cell charge is shared with these four bulbs, 1/4. Yes, 1/4 of the bulb intensity of the charge is with 1/4 of 1 volt, 1 by 4th charge of the volt is passed through in this circuit. Got it? Is there any doubt, students? If you don't understand, you repeatedly watch it and you will understand. Okay? This type of connection, positive, negative, positive and negative. See, different charges are connected in series. This connection is called what? Series connection of bulbs. Series connection of bulbs. Okay, students? Now let us take right here, positive and negative. What's here? Bulb. Yeah. Do you think the bulb is glowing here? Yes, because the switch is in on position. The bulb is glowing. Okay. This battery cell, 1 volt for example, the charge produced by this battery cell, only one battery cell we took, right? This charge, for example, 1 volt of charge is produced by one battery cell. And now I am going to increase the number of bulbs there. You know how I increase the number of bulbs in that series connection of bulbs there? Here, I'll increase the number of bulbs, but the arrangement will be different. The connection will be different. Here, see, the connection of the wires or the bulbs are like this. Students, only 1 volt of the charge produced by one battery cell is passed through these copper wires, and each bulb glows with 1 volt of charge. The brightness will be same. There will be no change in the brightness of the bulbs. Okay? 1 volt pass through all the copper wire. Same 1 volt is passed. But here in that connection, 1 volt is passing through the same path so that the charge is shared to all the bulbs there. Here the charge is not shared. Only 1 volt of the charge is passed through this copper wire, this copper wire, this copper wire, this copper wire, and through each and every bulb here. And then the intensity of the bulb will be same. Okay? So this type of connection is called parallel connection of bulbs. Parallel connection of bulbs. Students, the arrangement of the electrical components are in different manner. Series connection and parallel connection. So in this video, what we have learned, students? The types of connections, parallel connection and series connection. Parallel connection with different batteries and parallel connection with different bulbs, and series connection with different batteries, and series connection with different bulbs. So in this video, that's for this video, students, and I hope you all understood, and I want you to write the difference between you have to collect information about what is the difference between parallel and series connection of battery cells. Okay, the arrangement may be with bulbs or maybe with battery cells. Okay, and this arrangement makes us to understand how the circuit is, how the circuit, you know, parallel circuit or series circuit. Okay students, this is for this video. Thank you for listening, and thank you one and all.